11:23 on a Thursday, you know the rules. We're talking to Eric Raddatz from Florida Weekly. He is calling in live. Eric, if you can hear us, I have to introduce you to the newest member of our team, Kyla Gaylor.
Hey, Eric.
Well, welcome. Welcome. Nice to meet you here virtually.
Well, we look forward to having you back in the studio when it's safe, Eric, but we're going to begin this week's edition talking about how the pandemic has really impacted, of course, a lot of jobs here in Florida, and you're profiling specific stories of people in our community.
Yes, we took a look, and we all know or have been affected by unemployment here in Florida. This pandemic has taken a hit. We found out almost 3 million Floridians applied for unemployment during the pandemic. And within these 3 million, that's about a fifth of our Florida workforce. It's quite a bit. And sometimes within those numbers, some of the stories get lost. So we take a look at three specific Floridians who were affected and what their stories were like with the system of getting unemployment money, only really originally being able to hold about 20,000 through the website, now being hit with 3 million applicants, what it meant for them, and as we look forward into the new year, more positive things, but also we consider everyone's story important, and we tell these Floridian stories in this week's Florida Weekly.
Definitely difficult times for a lot of people in our community right now. So let's talk business. We know COVID has affected career women more than men. So what can you tell us about that?
Well, it seems to be the case. And that being the case, we have to take a look at the reasons why and what tips there might be so that there isn't absolute discouragement. And this week we take a look at the reasons why and and expert advice as to looking forward, just exactly what would be helpful moving into 2021. For those women who have been more impacted by the coronavirus. It's kind of a coronavirus whammy. We get into some tips to stay hopeful in the new year.
Well, one man in Collier County is living his best life. He has turned his dreams into his career, and we're talking multiple careers. Talk to us about Tyler McDonald, Eric.
Well, one thing for sure is that he is quite a talent. His photography has proven it. He happens to be featured in the fifth annual Mark Mercado Arts Festival. And we take a look at him, not just in regards to his art, but also he's making his own guitars. When we sit down, he's only 15 years old. So he's real talent. We sit down and talk about his passions, his ambitions, his inspirations, and where you can see his work.
And we know a lot of people, of course, are staying home right now, but there are some people who feel comfortable going out. So what is there to do in the community for those people?
Well, we tell you, we can always take a look at a full calendar of events in Florida Weekly. This week, we happen to feature also top picks. So we have Happy Days down at the Broadway Palm Theater. There's Biz Arts, Big Arts Trio of Strings, comedy shows, live music, and much more. Always pick us up on stands online and on your device for cool things to do in town virtually and also cool things to do in person, floridaweekly.com.
You heard it here first. Eric, thank you very much for reporting live from the field. I understand you're in between meetings right now, so go get a coffee and keep it going.
Will do. Thanks. Happy New Year, guys.
You too.